Gives this bride away?
My wife and I do.
Please join us, remain standing and join us while we take a few minutes to worship together. Celebration of your union, of your wedding, your marriage, something that God has ordained from the very beginning. And so we join in celebration. I thank you because Mark and Cindy have been members of our fellowship group for some time, and we've come to know them, come to love them. and they've asked me to preside over their vows, for which I consider a great honor. And so we join together in your celebration along with you for your union and your marriage. God ordained it from the very beginning. God himself is a God of communion. Between the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, they've always existed together, and they've always had relationship with each other. He created the heavens and the earth, created all things that we know. Then he created man, and he created man in his own image. And I believe part of that image in which he created man with the same attributes that God had, and that was the need and the urge for communion and relationship. And so when God created Adam, he said it's everything else when he created, he said it is good, but he didn't say it was finished. When he finished with Adam, he said it is not good that Adam should be, that man should be alone. And so he created for him Eve, his helpmate. And I just think for a moment, can you imagine when God presented Eve to Adam the first time he laid eyes on her? I'm sure he said yes. Imagine what was running through his mind. All the beauty in a woman that we've come to know throughout history and in the world today was embodied in that gift that God gave to Adam, Eve. And not only did God give Eve as a gift to Adam, but he gave Adam as a gift to Eve. And they became one. One spirit, one mind. God instituted that from the very beginning so that we would not be alone. Scriptures tell us that marriage is a covenant between a man and a woman. And it's a covenant also between God. No marriage can be successful. No marriage can prosper to its fullest extent as God had intended, unless God is at the very center of your marriage. I also, as I was reflecting this morning about your wedding and marriage, I was also thinking there is coming a wedding and a marriage that all of us will be attending, and all the celebration, all of the things that you've done so far to prepare doesn't compare. It's a shadow to the great wedding and marriage feast of the Lamb, in which you and I, all those that believe in Christ, will join in the wedding and celebration of all the ages, in which we will be joined with him for eternity. And we all look forward to that day. And the Word of God tells us, and Paul tells us, that's our great hope, is his coming to receive us as his bride. So you can see the importance that God placed on marriage from the very beginning, in that he set it as a prototype for the relationship between himself, his son, and his bride, which is you and I, when he comes again to return for us. So we're all witnesses here, but God is also a witness of your vows, of your commitment to each other. And it's a three-way union between your commitment to Mark, Mark's commitment to Christy, and that both of you and your commitment to God. There's no more important relationship. I can share this from personal experience as well, but I personally believe there will be no more important relationship apart from your relationship with Christ than your union. It will be the means by which God will bring you and conform you and transform you into his image. As iron sharpens iron, he will use you, Mark, to influence Christy. And Christy, God will use you to help make Mark into the man that God intends. And I truly believe that you look back in the twilight of your years and reflect with the realization that this is the best thing you have ever done. Mark, there's a promise that comes, Peter tells us. We're commanded to love our wives in the same manner that Christ loved the church, in that he gave up his life for the church. He gave up his life.